Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Isn't it glorious outside?
Yes. Yeah.
I deliberately had a very early breakfast, so I had an excuse to sit outside and wait for my bride. And there were three sparrows that were having a conversation. And they were talking to each other, and I felt like I was at a concert. It was so beautiful. Although the world is full of suffering, it is also full of the overcoming of it. That's some of Helen Keller's wisdom. The universe speaks in many languages, but only one voice. It speaks in the language of hope. It speaks in the language of trust. It speaks in the language of strength and the language of compassion. It is the language of the heart and the language of the soul. But always, it is the same voice. It's the voice of our ancestors speaking through us and the voice of our inheritors waiting to be born. The small, still voice that says, we are one. No matter the blood, no matter the skin, no matter the world, no matter the star, we are one. No matter the pain, no matter the darkness, no matter the loss, no matter the fear, we are one. Here, gathered together in common cause, we begin to realize this singular truth and this singular rule that we must be kind to one another. Because each voice enriches us and ennobles us, and each voice lost diminishes us. We are the voice of the universe, the soul of creation, the fire that will light our way to a better future. We are one. Healing does not mean curing, although the two words are often used interchangeably. While it may not be possible for us to cure ourselves or to find someone who can, it is always possible for us to heal ourselves. Healing implies the possibility for us to relate differently to illness, disability, even death, as we learn to see with eyes of wholeness. Healing is coming to terms with things as they are.